welcome to the session. In this session, we'll learn about conjugate and properties of conjugates of complex numbers. First of all, let us discuss conjugate of a complex number. If a complex number z is equal to a plus b iota, then the number a minus b iota is called the complex conjugate or simply conjugate of a plus b iota and is denoted by conjugate of z. That is, conjugate of z is equal to a minus b iota. So we can obtain the conjugate of a complex number by simply changing the sign of the imaginary part in the given complex number. Now let us see one example. Here z is equal to 5 plus 7 iota, then conjugate of z is equal to the conjugate of 5 plus 7 iota, which is equal to, now where we will change the sign of the imaginary part? So we will change the sign and it will be 5 minus 7 iota. Now let us discuss the second example. Let the complex number is equal to minus 2 minus 3 iota, then the conjugate of z is equal to the conjugate of minus 2 minus 3 iota. And here again, we will change the sign of the imaginary part. So it will be equal to minus 2 plus 3 iota. Therefore, we can say that the conjugate of a complex number is formed by changing the sign of the imaginary part of the given complex number. Now let us discuss this geometrically. Here the point Pxy represents the number, that is the complex number z, which is equal to x plus y iota, and the point Q represents the conjugate number, that is the conjugate of z, which is equal to x minus y iota, and the coordinates of the point Q are x minus y, and this point Q is the reflection or image of the point P in the real axis. And the point R, whose coordinates are minus x minus y, represents the complex number minus z, which is equal to minus x minus y iota. And this point R is the reflection of the point Q in the imaginary axis. Therefore, we can say that minus z is the reflection of the conjugate of z in the imaginary axis. Now let us discuss properties of conjugates of complex numbers. Now let us discuss the first property, that is, the conjugate of the conjugate of a complex number is the complex number itself. That is, if z is a complex number, then conjugate of the conjugate of a complex number is equal to the complex number itself. Now let us prove this. Now let z is equal to x plus y iota. Then the conjugate of z is equal to, now here we will change the sign of the imaginary part. So this will be equal to x minus y iota. And now the conjugate of the conjugate of complex number is equal to the conjugate of x minus y iota, which is equal to, now here also we will change the sign of the imaginary part, so this will be equal to x plus y iota, which is equal to the complex number itself. Therefore, we have proved the first property. Now, let us discuss the second property. Now, the second property is, a complex number is equal to its conjugate if and only if it is purely real. That means, now let us take z as a complex number. So, a complex number is equal to its conjugate. That is, z is equal to the conjugate of z if and only if the complex number, that is z, is purely real. Now let us prove this property. Now here, let z is equal to x plus y iota, then this complex number is equal to the conjugate of this complex number, that is z is equal to the conjugate of z, if and only if z, which is equal to x plus y iota, is equal to the conjugate of z, that is the conjugate of x plus y iota, if and only if x plus y iota is equal to, now the conjugate of this number is x minus y iota, if and only if x minus x plus y iota plus y iota is equal to 0, if and only if 2y iota is equal to 0, as these terms are cancelled with each other, if and only if y is equal to 0. If and only if, now y is the imaginary part of the complex number z, which is equal to 0. Now in the number x plus y iota, y is called the imaginary part, and if y is equal to 0, then that means the complex number is purely real. So the imaginary part of the complex number is equal to 0 if and only if the complex number is purely real. Therefore, a complex number is equal to its conjugate if and only if the complex number is purely real. Now let us discuss the third property. And the third property is, the conjugate of the sum of two complex numbers is the sum of their conjugates. That is, if z1 and z2 are two complex numbers, then the conjugate of the sum of the two complex numbers, that means the conjugate of z1 plus z2 is equal to the sum of their conjugates. That means this is equal to the conjugate of z1 plus the conjugate of z2. Now let us prove this property. For this, let us take the complex number z1 is equal to x1 plus y1 iota, and the complex number is z2 is equal to x2 plus y2 iota. Then the conjugate of the complex number z1 is equal to the conjugate of this number, which is equal to x1 minus y1 iota. And the conjugate of z2 will be equal to the conjugate of this number, which is equal to x2 minus y2 iota. Now, conjugate of z1 plus conjugate of z2 is equal to x1 minus y1 iota the whole plus x2 minus y2 iota the whole, which is further equal to x1 plus x2 the whole minus y1 plus y2 the whole into iota. Now let us find the conjugate of z1 plus z2, which will be equal to the conjugate of x1 plus y1 iota plus x2 plus y2 iota the whole. Now this can be further written as conjugate of x1 plus x2 the whole plus y1 plus y2 the whole into iota. Now the conjugate of this number can be obtained by changing the sign of the imaginary part. So this will be equal to x1 plus x2 the whole minus y1 plus y2 the whole into iota. Now let us name this as equation number 1, this as equation number 2. Now the right hand side of both of these equations are same. Therefore, from 1 and 2, we get the conjugate of z1 plus z2 is equal to conjugate of z1 plus conjugate of z2. Now let us discuss the next property, according to which the conjugate of the difference of two complex numbers is equal to the difference of their conjugates. That is, if z1 and z2 are two complex numbers, then the conjugate of z1 minus z2 is equal to conjugate of z1 minus conjugate of z2. Now let us prove this property. As is, let the complex number z1 is equal to x1 plus y1 iota and the complex number z2 is equal to x2 plus y2 iota. Now the conjugate of z1 minus z2 is equal to the conjugate of x1 plus y1 iota the whole minus x2 plus y2 iota the whole, which can be further written as conjugate of x1 minus x2 the whole plus y1 minus y2 the whole into iota. Now the conjugate of this number can be obtained by changing the sign of the imaginary part. So this will be equal to x1 minus x2 the whole minus y1 minus y2 the whole into iota. Further, this can be written as x1 minus y1 iota the whole minus x2 minus y2 iota the whole. Now the conjugate of z1 is equal to x1 minus y1 iota and the conjugate of z2 is equal to x2 minus y2 iota. So this number is equal to the conjugate of z1 minus x2 minus y2 iota is the conjugate of z2. Therefore, conjugate of the difference of two complex numbers is equal to the difference of their conjugates. Now let us discuss the next property, which is the conjugate of the product of two complex numbers is the product of two conjugates. That is, if Z1 and Z2 are two complex numbers, then the conjugate of Z1 into Z2 is equal to conjugate of Z1 into conjugate of Z2. Now let us prove this property. Now here also we will take Z1 is equal to X1 plus Y1 iota, Z2 is equal to X2 plus Y2 iota, and hence conjugate of Z1 and conjugate of Z2. Now, conjugate of Z1 into Z2 is equal to conjugate of X1 plus Y1 iota the whole into X2 plus Y2 iota the whole. Now, multiplying, we obtain conjugate of X1, X2 minus, as iota square is minus 1, so it will be minus y1, y2 the whole plus x1, y2 plus x2, y1 the whole into iota. Now here also we can obtain the conjugate of this number by changing the sign of the imaginary part. So this will be equal to x1, x2 minus y1, y2 the whole minus x1, y2 plus x2, y1 the whole into iota. Now, conjugate of z1 into conjugate of z2 will be equal to x1 minus y1 iota the whole into x2 minus y2 iota the whole, which is equal to, now on multiplying we obtain x1, x2 minus y1, y2 the whole minus x1, y2 plus y1, x2 the whole into iota. Now both of these expressions are same, that is they are equal. Therefore, conjugate of z1 into z2 is equal to conjugate of z1 into conjugate of z2. And in general, we can write the conjugate of z1 into z2 into z3 and so on up to zn is equal to conjugate of z1 into conjugate of z2 into conjugate of z3 and so on up to conjugate of zn. Now let us discuss the next property, which is the conjugate of the quotient of two complex numbers. The non-zero denominators is the quotient of their conjugates. That is, the conjugate of z1 over z2, where z1 and z2 be two complex numbers, is equal to the conjugate of z1 over conjugate of z2. Now let us start with its proof. Now conjugate of z1 over z2 is equal to conjugate of x1 plus y1 iota whole upon x2 plus y2 iota the whole. Now rationalizing the denominator, by multiplying the numerator and denominator by the conjugate of the denominator. Now the conjugate of the denominator is x2 minus y2 iota. So this will be equal to the conjugate of x1 plus y1 iota whole upon x2 plus y2 iota the whole into x2 minus y2 iota the whole over x2 minus y2 iota the whole. Now on solving, this will be equal to conjugate of x1 x2 plus y1 y2 the whole plus x2 y1 minus x1 y2 the whole into iota all upon x2 square plus y2 square as iota square is equal to minus 1 further this is equal to x1 x2 plus y1 y2 the whole now for the conjugate we will change the sign of the imaginary part so this will be minus x2 y1 minus x1 y2 the whole into iota all upon x2 square plus y2 square now this whole expression is the value of conjugate of z1 over z2 the whole now let us see equation A now let us find conjugate of z1 over conjugate of z2 now this is equal to now conjugate of z1 is x1 minus y1 iota whole upon conjugate of z2 is x2 minus y2 iota now on rationalizing the denominator this will be equal to x1 minus y1 iota the whole into x2 plus y2 iota the whole whole upon x2 minus y2 iota the whole into x2 plus y2 iota the whole which implies conjugate of z1 over conjugate of z2 is equal to x1 x2 plus y1 y2 the whole minus x2 y1 minus x1 y2 the whole into iota all upon x2 square plus y2 square now let this be equation B now from A and B we have conjugate of z1 over z2 the whole is equal to conjugate of z1 over conjugate of z2 as the right hand side of the equation A and B are equal now let us discuss the next property which is the square of the conjugate of a complex number is equal to the conjugate of the square of that complex number that is if z is a complex number then the square of the conjugate of z is equal to the conjugate of the square of z now let us prove this property now let the complex number z is equal to x plus y iota then the conjugate of z is equal to x minus y iota now let us find the square of the conjugate of z which will be equal to x minus y iota whole square now applying the formula of a minus b whole square this will be equal to x square plus iota square y square now iota square is minus 1 so it will be x square minus y square the whole minus 2xy iota now let us find z square will be equal to x plus y iota whole square now applying the formula of a plus b whole square which is x square now here also iota square is minus 1 so it will be x square minus y square the whole plus 2xy iota now the conjugate of the square of z will be equal to the conjugate of this number which will be equal to x square minus y square the whole now here changing the sign of the imaginary part so this will be minus 2xy iota now let this be equation A and this be equation B from A and B we have the square of the conjugate of z is equal to the conjugate of the square of set. So these are the various properties of conjugates of complex numbers. So in this session you have learnt about conjugate of a complex number and properties of conjugates of complex numbers. So this completes our session. Hope you all have enjoyed the session.